Guys and girls, Zelda Tears of the Kingdom is coming quick. We got another trailer today. We got confirmation of the $70 price point. This game is officially 70 bucks. It is 70 bucks through and through. There's no explanation why. I will point out that they just announced a collector's edition for 130, but they did not announce a collector's edition system. The Switch Pro hype and hope lives on, but check this out right here. This is $130. The game. The steelbook. The pin set. The steel poster. The art book, probably the hottest item. Limited availability. May 12th. Is that worth $130? So just to take us to the, here, give us this picture again. You're getting a steel book, a pin set, an art book, and a steel poster for 60 extra dollars. So like, let's price this out here. Steel book, what, $5? Is it, okay, 10 bucks. Let's say steel book is $10. Steel poster, $10, that's 20. Art book, what, 20, that's 40. Pin set, the hard part is, like, these are not things that I would really thoroughly enjoy. If I was to ask for a collector's edition, I'd want, like, a sick statue. I would want some cool piece of clothing. I'd want something awesome. I have Zelda posters. A steel poster doesn't really do it for me. Nintendo so rarely does collector's editions that you do have to appreciate when they do one. But I wish that they were able to deliver us something that was more exciting. This is their biggest game of the year, maybe their biggest launch of the generation. And I feel like the collector's edition is pricey for what you're getting. The art book is standard. The pin set, I guess, is a little unique. But if you're not a big pin person, then this sort of feels like a boring package. Art books are expensive. But I don't know. I mean, $70 for the base game already makes this a premium product. Nintendo's first ever $70 game. There's no real indication. Like, the trailer was good, right? The trailer was good. I'll pull it up for you now so we can run it. But there's no indication necessarily on what makes this such a special new Zelda. Like, it's a new Zelda, and Ganon is very angry, but we don't know so much. So it's $70. They are keeping that real low-key. They're just like, oh, it's $70. And in case you don't believe me, it's up on the page. Metroid, they did us nice, $39.99. Zelda, 70 bucks. The base version is 70. And again, this collector's edition we're talking about today is 130. It feels expensive. It feels like a lot. Like I said, angry Ganon. Zelda is having somebody lend their power to Link because he needs help, because she's like, I don't think you can beat him this time. Man, no faith from our girlfriend. No faith. No faith from Princess. How many times have we saved her before? Come on, you gotta believe in Link. Look how good this guy does for you. But, you know, it's an interesting world where we're paying $70 for the next Nintendo Switch game. And it's an interesting world where we're paying $130 for the collector's edition. Do you think it's worth it? The thing I want to point out to you that I think is really important to note with this collector's edition is that it is going to be much more expensive after launch. If you do not get this for $130 on May 12th, since they're already saying that it is limited, you will pay $300 on eBay. That's just the way it goes. Things for, you know, Fire Emblem collector's edition go way up in price. Plenty of things go way up in price when it's a Nintendo Collector's Edition, because they do so few. So I believe you want this, you're gonna have to fork it over. I personally do not think it's worth the price. I don't need a steelbook. Personally, I'd rather have the game digitally. And a steel poster, didn't we get like a special map last time? I'm pretty sure that we got a map. And was there a statue? Or just the amiibo? Maybe there'll be more amiibo. We have one Zelda amiibo. I don't know if I have a picture of it here for you. One Zelda, let me see if I can pull it up. One Zelda amiibo so far. The last amiibo there was a lot. There was some really large ones. Yeah, as of right now, we just have this amiibo. This singular amiibo is what we've got. Link using his fiery ghost hand to say, hello, Zelda, I will save you. And then, you know, we have this collector's edition, as you can see, a little bit more up close. A look at the art book. Art books are always nice. I think those are really fun. With an amiibo also launching on May 12th, but no console. And I do want to talk about that, because there was big rumors and leaks about a Switch OLED Zelda. And you think they would have announced it here because they would want to launch it about a month before. That's what they've done with the consoles. That's what they did with the Smash Brothers console. That's what they did with the Splatoon console, the Pokemon console. They give it about a month of lead time so that people can get excited, get the system, and then get the game. There is not much time to announce that. It would be coming out in April, April 12th, April 15th, April 20th, if there was one. And so there isn't, it doesn't seem like there's gonna be an OLED. Now, me being Mr. Wild, I believe that this is still a kernel of hope that Zelda Tears of the Kingdom is a dual platform game. Zelda Tears of the Kingdom could still launch on a Switch Pro, primarily because they did not show off a ton of the game. They still are not fully showing the game. We have never seen an actual gameplay. We're seeing all sorts of cinematic shots, all sorts of nicely cut up pieces, but we're not seeing real gameplay. Is it because it's not ready? No. The game is out in 3 months. Is it because it's better than we think? Maybe. Is it because they're saving it for a separate Zelda Direct? I think that's the more likely option, but I want to throw out there, there is a chance this is a cross-gen release, just like the past three Legend of Zelda games. There is a chance. There really, really is a chance. They've done it before. They did not throw out the OLED model. Why not do an OLED for Zelda when you did one for Splatoon and Pokemon, and Zelda is, that's the collector's minefield. They're doing a collector's edition, 130 for that. People would go get that and the OLED Switch, but there is not one. So perhaps there indeed will be a Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom on Switch Pro. I'm just throwing it out there. We still have time for that to happen. But in the meantime, you got to decide about $130 collector's edition. You got to decide about $70 Zelda. And the sad news is that everybody is going to buy Zelda at 70. And, you know, you probably won't feel bad. It's not like, oh, 70 for a new PlayStation game and 70 for this Zelda aren't equal. It just feels weird because, hey, we have no reason. They justified the $70 on the new consoles because of insane graphics and expanding cost, huge team sizes, great art requests, and just a ton of development time and cost. This game has had a ton of development time. I mean, I'm sure it cost a decent amount, but what makes Tears of the Kingdom their first 70? And is it because there's a Switch Pro lurking? Or is it because they just want to raise prices? Again, it's very interesting what they're doing today. It's very interesting how this is all taking shape. And it's very interesting that we still have very little, next to no gameplay info on what the heck you do in Tears of the Kingdom. So little. But we do have a collector's edition. We do have Game Boy. We do have Game Boy Advance. We do have super sick Metroid Prime Remaster that I cannot wait to download. And I think in general, it was a pretty fun show because of how much is just out there. This collector's edition, though, that's what I want to know in the comments down below. Are you going to get this $130 edition? Because it's such an important game. Like, this is the big thing for Nintendo. The pins look fun, although I gotta say, I used to be a pin person, not so much anymore. A steel poster, I don't like steel art. I like the posters I have. It's just like regular canvas or regular printed paper, and you frame them and put them up. I don't necessarily love steel. I don't get it. I know some people love it, but $130, I'm skipping. If you want it though, it will go up in price significantly on eBay. It's good it did not get delayed. Like, that's maybe the biggest victory. But I'm just saying, kind of a weird rollout. Not a ton of info, a pretty short trailer. They're saving either for a direct or they're saving because there's another system. I will bet money it's one of the two. You can pick which one. Probably the former, possibly the latter. But yeah, this is our new Zelda, and she doesn't have confidence in Link, which is throwing me for a bit of a loop. All right, I'm very excited though. May 12th can't come soon enough. 90 days away, it's gonna be a long 90 days, but there isn't a console to tide us over. Super suspicious. Why do you think that is? They just decided to skip out on Zelda? It's so weird. No special edition consoles, no Joy-Con, no Pro Controller for Breath of the Wild or for Tears of the Kingdom, the sequel. So strange. Skyward Sword Joy-Con, no Breath of the Wild anything. No Tears of the Kingdom anything. I'm still hoping for Switch Pro. Let me know what you think in the comments down below, everybody. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, stay positive out there. Until next time, love you lots. Switch Force out.